When the world first learned about the Josh Duggar sex scandals, many critics of the Duggar clan hoped that the news would bring an end to Jim Bob's ultra-lucrative media empire. But against all odds, the Duggar money train kept chugging along, and Jim Bob successfully swept his son's sex crimes under the carpet. Thankfully, one of Josh and Jim Bob's victims is now speaking out and calling attention to the trauma those two men have caused. Jill Duggar is no longer on speaking terms with her parents, which means she's finally free to express herself as she sees fit. This freedom has deepened the divide, as Jill is finally free to share her feelings about the man who molested her and the man who protected her molester. Along with her husband, Derek Dillard, Jill has been posting YouTube videos in which she speaks candidly about her troubled relationship with her birth family. This week, a fan asked if Jill and Derek have returned to the Duggar big house in the months since Dillard's feud with Jim Bob got them banned. We already knew that the Dillards skipped this year's holiday festivities as a result of bad blood within the family, but now it looks as though the couple has been steering clear of Jill's childhood home for even longer than we realize. It's been at least a few years, Derek said in response to a fan's query. Asked if they're ever invited to Duggar events, Jill clarified that they avoid the house by choice. "It depends," she replied. "Yes, we're invited to a lot of events. It depends, though." "There's a lot of triggers there," Derek chimed in. Jill did not disagree with her husband's observations that she finds the household triggering. "There's some restrictions about us going there, but also we just feel that in this season of life, we have to prioritize our mental and emotional health, and our threshold, as we like to call it, is just a little bit lower in this season of life for us with a lot going on in our lives," she said. "Plus COVID makes it a lot harder with just trying to keep our circle smaller," Jill added. "We would like for it not to stay that way, but that's where we are right now." The Duggars don't believe in COVID, but the Dillards do, and they've been taking the necessary precautions. However, it sounds like Jill and Derek will be keeping their distance even after the whole crew is vaccinated, assuming Jim Bob allows his kids to be vaccinated. From there, Jill and Derek continued to go against the Duggar belief system by stating that if they ever have a daughter, they will prepare her to enter the workforce and be independent. "Yes, that's important whether you have a son or a daughter," Derek said. "I think we've raised both of our sons to be as independent as possible. We don't want, like, 30-year-old kids living in our basement and not being productive," he added. "Even if you want to be a stay-at-home mom, that's great, but if your spouse dies and you're left in the situation where you need to have more flexibility, it's helpful having tools in your tool belt to get done what you need to get done," Derek said. "Or if you want to be a working mom or working wife with no kids, you don't want to raise somebody to be reliant on anyone," Jill said. "It's good to have a healthy level of independence." As the Ashley's Reality Roundup points out, that comment could be interpreted as an insult to Jenna Duggar, who's currently 31, unemployed and living at home with her parents. But hey, if there's any truth to the rumors about Jenna being courted by Steven Wiseman, she could be the next Duggar daughter to be set free, and we just can't wait to hear what she'll have to say about life under the Jim Bob regime. That's it for now, thank you for watching, please subscribe to stay tuned.